Alright, so this is going to be a video about why calculus was created. The name actually gives away a lot of what calculus is essentially about. In Latin, calculus means small pebble, used for counting, kind of like an abacus. This small pebble can lead to some really big ideas. Fun fact, the translation of small pebble also is why calculus is used as a term in dentistry, although with a very much different meaning. These small pebbles are used to solve two major problems in math: the slope of a point and the area of a plane. You might be thinking, slope and area? Those aren't that difficult of concepts. Why would we need an entire branch of mathematics dedicated to seemingly straightforward concepts? Well, like many things in mathematics, simple concepts can have tremendous implications that the original creators of calculus never actually dreamt of. These implications are beyond the scope of this video, but will be covered throughout the course. The implications of calculus are far-reaching and used in every branch of physical sciences, actuarial science, computer science, statistics, engineering, economics, business, medicine, and in any field whenever the problem can be mathematically modeled and a best case scenario solution is desired. This will be further covered throughout the course. So getting back to these slope and area concepts, slope is simply found by using the coordinates of two points in the following equation. It is defined as the ratio between the vertical distance between two points and the horizontal distance between two points. So it's a ratio of those two distances. The emphasis here is on two points. Slope, by definition, needs two points. So how can you find the slope of one point if the slope is based on two? The answer is calculus. Now let's talk about area. So far, you should be able to find the area of certain shapes. These equations to find area were covered in your geometry class, but why would anyone need calculus to find the area when we have these equations already? Well, geometry is great for finding area of really basic shapes, but looking at the world around you, it is evident that most things tend to not be basic shapes. How can you find the area of these non-basic shapes? The answer, once again, is calculus. Throughout this course, I want you to frame your mind to think about these two problems. All of calculus is based on the slope of a point, the area of a plane, and the implications of those two ideas. So that's a brief overview of why calculus was created. If you have any questions about anything in this video, let me know.